In this tutorial, I'm going to write a servlet that serves XML data to web browsers. So I'm going to start by creating an Eclipse web application, and then I'm going to write that servlet serving XML data to a web client, and then I'm going to test run this application on a Tomcat web server with more than one XML file. I'll start by creating a new project. I'm going to call it XML server project, and the target runtime is going to be Apache Tomcat 7. And I'm going to create here a directory. I'm going to call it XML files. And inside it, I'm going to have one XML file. So one XML file for now that I'm going to be reading and displaying in the browser. And I'm also going to create a servlet that I'm going to call XML servlet. And the package is going to be com.va.tutorial. I'm only going to have a doGet method. So the request coming from the browser is going to have a parameter. I'm going to call it file name. That is gonna ask for a file in the XML files directory. For now, I just have XML file 01, so it's gonna ask for this XML file 01, and it would be returned to the browser and it would be displayed as an XML. So if this request parameter is supplied in the request, then I'm gonna go ahead and do some processing here. I'm gonna cast the request object to a string, and so that's just gonna be the file name. I also need to define the file location, so it's gonna be this XML files, so slash XML files, and I need a pointer to this file resource, so I'm gonna use URL. I'm gonna use the servlet context and call the get resource method on it and pass it the file location slash file name. So which I'm gonna get to whatever file is under the XML files that I need and that is requested from as a parameter, so as a file name parameter value. And since I'm going to be returning XML data, I'm going to set the content type as text slash XML. So response.setContentType text slash XML. And let me pick up a print writer instance. So from the response, I'm going to do get writer and pick up a print writer instance so that I can write back to the browser. I need to read the content of this XML file and write it back to the browser, so I'm gonna use here to do that I'm gonna use the URL here, from here, URL instance, and call open connection on it to get a URL connection. And I'm gonna use this URL connection to call connect and connect to this resource, to this XML file. And then I'm gonna pick up, so use the URL connection to pick up an input stream instance, and then use that input stream instance in order to instantiate a buffered input stream. And now I can start reading from this XML file. So I can do buffered input stream dot read. So I'm gonna be reading bytes of data, and what indicates to me that I reached the last byte is when byte of data read is equal to -1. So if byte of data read is different than -1, then I can keep reading. So, and byte of data read is what is returning from buffered input stream dot read. So initially I'm gonna print this first byte of data that I read here. So I'm gonna write it, use the print writer to write it so that I can send it back to the client. Then I'm gonna keep reading more bytes of data, and until I reach a byte of data which is equal to -1, then I'm gonna exit this while loop. Let me do a save all. And let me go ahead and close the print writer. And also close this buffered input stream. Probably should put this in a try catch finally block, so this would end up the closing of the print writer, and the closing of the buffered input stream would end up in the finally block. But for now, let's just do it this way. So file, save all. And to run it, I'm gonna run it on Tomcat 7. So I'm gonna add the file name is XML file 01.xml, this file. So here we go. So it read the file and it displayed it in the browser as XML data. So what if, since this is an XML server, so what if I have a different file? So let me put a different file with different contents. So XML file 02. Let's say it has this content, Java Enterprise Edition and Java Web Development, as opposed to XML 01, it has Java language and object-oriented design patterns. So and so I'm not gonna restart the server. I'm just gonna try to access this second file without restarting the server. So here I'm gonna have XML file 02. And here we go, so it's accessing it. So you can add as many XML files as you want while the server is running, and it can a client can access them through their browser.